Hi everyone and welcome back. It's the first of the month today and Altenew has released a new Paint a Flower stamp set. This is the Torch Ginger stamp set. It comes with lots of layers and it also is available along with the die, the matching die. All the Paint a Flower stamp sets are released on the first of the month and then they also come with the matching dies. So at the back you can see all the layers, but what I love about these stamp sets is that they also give you the outline design. So if you don't want to use the layers, you can use just the black lines and then color it with your favorite mediums. Now I'm going to show you the leaflet so you can take a look on how gorgeous this flower is going to be once stamped and colored. And for my project today, I decided to create a new page for my alphabet flower journal. So whenever Altenew comes up with a new flower stamp set that I don't have a letter for, then I grab the opportunity to make a page. I am determined to finish it off this year. So anyway, I'm going to put everything aside and I will work on my 6x6 page here. This is watercolor paper. I'm working inside the box since I'm playing with sprays today just to avoid the mess. And I'm going to play with a couple of sprays here from Altenew. These are metallic shimmer sprays and they give a lovely finish. Once it's dry, I'm going to try and catch the light for you so you can see how shiny it ends up. I think it has mica inside. The colors I used are frayed leaf for the green and warm sunshine for the yellow. Now, as always, you will find links to everything I used linked down below in the description area, and there is also a giveaway on my blog, so make sure to visit and join the giveaway. Now I'm going to use a stencil and I will work over it with another spray. This is an orange color and the color is called Sun Kissed, again one of the shimmer sprays by Altenew, and I'm going to spray in an area and then turn it around and just print with what's left in the stencil. Just to add some organic look, nothing is going to be perfect here since I'm working on an art journal. Now I'm going to place the stencil one more time over my project and with a baby wipe I'm going over some areas. Since this is a water-based spray, it's going to react with the water and it's going to give that ghost effect. The same effect that you get with dilution sprays, and you can either spray with water if you like and then blot with a clean paper towel or with a clean cloth like I'm doing here. Now the stencil with all the dots is again by Altenew and it's called Filling Dotty Stencil. And hopefully you can see here how shiny this page is due to the sprays. Now I'm going to do a couple more favorite techniques that I always like to do on my backgrounds. First of all, I'm going to use this text stamp and I'm going to stamp all over the background. I'm not going for the perfect impression here, just bits and pieces here and there. And I'm using a green ink for that, just because I know that I will have green details on my focal point, for example the leaves and the stems of the stem of my flower. Now I'm also going to add some white splashes. For the splashes I use the Pure White spray by Altenew and this has a matte finish. And I'm going to leave that aside to dry and I will start playing with my stamps. Now I'm going to create my focal point. First of all, I'm stamping with permanent black ink the outline. And I like to have black lines on my art journals, that's why I'm doing that. I also stamped it a couple of times just to make sure that I have a good crisp impression. And now I will move on coloring with all the different layers, the petals. I'm going with pinks for my torch ginger flower. The first layer was stamped with pink diamond. This is pink alicious. And it actually leaves some highlights on the tips of the petals. Then I'm going to add the third layer, which is lubellite. And since I believe that shadows really bring the images into life, I'm going to stamp it a couple of times to get a deeper color. And then the last and final layer is raspberry. And again for this layer, I'm going to stamp it a couple of times for an even deeper color as well. And you can see how these shadows really bring this flower to life. It really makes it pop and it actually looks dimensional. Now I'm going to need two leaves for my focal point, so I'm going to switch as I'm stamping. And I first stamped with permanent black ink the outline, and then I'm going to move on and start stamping the three layers. For the first one, I went with grass field. The second layer is stamped with Shadow Creek. And the third and deepest color is Mountain Pine. Just like always, you will find everything linked below. Now that I have everything stamped, I can use the matching dies to cut them out. However, I prefer to use my scissors and fuzzy cut them, since I don't like to have that white border all around them when it comes to my art journaling. However, if this was a card, I would definitely use the matching dies. I'm also going to need a stem for my focal point, so I will use one of the ink pads that I used for the flowers, for the leaves, sorry. And I'm going to just swipe it over a scrap piece of paper. I can even add a shadow on one end. And then I'm going to use my big scissors and cut out a strip of paper. So there is my stem. I'm also using a black marker and I will go all around the edges. This is going to get rid of that white edge and it's also going to cover up any mistakes that I did while cutting out the leaves and the petals. And it's going to look as if I did a perfect job. Now back to my background, and I'm adding just a touch of a rusty hinge all over the edges. This is brownish but orange as well, so it matches the colors of my background. And I'm going to darken up only the very edge of my paper with black soot. I'm using my blending tools for that, and I'm staying only at the very edge. I don't want to bring that darker color towards the center. Another favorite technique that I go back to again and again is to use a text stamp and to go all around the edges with black ink and create kind of a frame. And I can keep on adding little bits and pieces on my background forever. I absolutely love creating backgrounds that will bring the focal point into life. Now I'm going to do something else. I'm going to bring in some washi tape. This is a washi tape from a very from an old release by Altenew. It's the Graph die cut tape. I'm going to cut out pieces with my fingers, making sure that nothing is completely perfect, and I'm going to stick it in different areas. I like to work in threes, so I will try and position these cutouts in three different areas around my page. I absolutely love the fact that it looks like a fence. It also is white, which means that it's going to bring some light into my page. And then on top, I'm going to use a couple more washi tapes just to add some extra color. One of my favorites by Altenew is this one with the plus signs. I love it for art journaling. And I'm also going to use another one that has a very thin strip of gold in the middle. I love how this is going to bring some shine on my page that matches with the background, since it already is shiny from the sprays. So now I'm finally happy with how my background is looking, and now it's time to stick everything down. I'm placing everything down by using my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back, and of course you can use your matte medium or anything else that you have. Just keep in mind that the sprays that I used at the background are water-based and they are going to react with water or any other type of medium that you place on top, so you need to be careful. That's why I chose to go with my Nouveau Deluxe, being really careful not to smudge or smear the colors underneath. Now I'm going to stick down the stem and the leaves. And remember that the leaves are identical, however, the way you place them down, they are going to look as if they are completely different. Now, with my blending tool, I'm going to make sure that I ink up the edges one more time so they don't stick as white as they are at the moment. And I will go with my blending tool that I used for the rusty hinge, just lightly over the white areas to tone them down a little bit. Now for my favorite technique that I always like to do, I'm bringing in my white gel pen and a very thin black marker, and I'm going to go all around the cutouts, adding some sketchy lines. These black lines are going to help all those cutouts to stand out against the background. I'm going to do it on the stem since it doesn't have any black lines from stamping. This is a piece that I created by my own. And if you add tiny little black lines around the petals, you will see that it's going to make them even more dimensional. I'm not being neat again, this is an art journal and I like to have sketchy lines which aren't perfect. Now it's time for my white gel pen, adding highlights here and there. Shadows and highlights really bring your focal points into life, they make them look dimensional. And for me is a lovely touch that I always like to do. Here is a close-up look where you can see exactly what I'm doing, adding highlights here on the leaves, on one side of the stem. You can also use your black marker or your white marker to add some lines all around, just to frame your art a little bit more. Doodling is always fun. And now, since this is a page for my flower art journal, I'm going to cut out the letter T out of black cardstock, and I always like to use my handy little die cut here since it's so small and it doesn't take a lot of space. I am playing around with the letter T to decide where this would look better, and I think up there is a nice spot for that. And now for the rest of the word, I could go on my printer and print out torch ginger. Instead, I decided to do some cutouts with those stickers. I like to cut out different letters and put them together to create my words, and that's exactly what I did here. By the way, this is a sticker book by Tim Holtz. So after playing around a little bit, I put together the two words, torch ginger. Now I'm adding some glue at the back of the letter T. And I'm going to place it down. I'm going to bring in my thin black marker and add some lines around the words. And to complete my sentiment, I'm going to bring in a couple of more stickers from that sticker book. I'm going to put together the phrase "Beyond Beautiful". I finally used the punch to add the holes on my page and put it back on my art journal. And this was the project for today, showcasing the new Paint a Flower stamp set by Altenew. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching today, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you.